Next chapter is materials for repair. The contents which are covered in this topic is number 1 concrete chemicals, number 2 special elements for accelerated strength gain, number 3 expansive cement, number 4 polymer concrete, number 5 sulfur infiltrated concrete, number 6 ferro cement, and number 7 fiber reinforced concrete. So these are the different contents which we are going to discuss in this chapter. Concrete chemicals. Normally, the admixtures are used to modify the properties of fresh and hardened concrete. They are classified as chemical and mineral admixtures. So, in the field, depends on the climatic conditions or depends on the concreting conditions or depends on the durability required, the many number of admixtures are available. So, the engineer or the RMC people normally used to prefer the admixture which is adaptable to that particular stage or adaptable to the particular site, depends on the climatic conditions. So that is the main purpose of the admixture. Chemical admixtures are used in construction industry for building strong, durable and waterproof structures. So normally in TV advertisements you can see that some admixtures they may advise that to use in the building at the time of concreting to increase the durability of the structure or the concrete as well as increase the life of the structure. Like that. So normally admixtures nowadays are very easily usable in the field by all type of people in the construction industry. So to make the structure durable as well as the concrete durable and also to make the structures more waterproof structure. So these are some of the examples of the concrete chemicals. So normally we see in the TV advertisements like Dr. Fixit, Forsock. These are the chemicals normally we use nowadays in the field, commonly adopted in the field. Depending on their use, chemical admixtures are used for following four main purposes. Number 1, some chemicals are mixed with concrete ingredients and spread throughout the body of concrete to favorably modify the setting properties of the concrete mix. Such chemicals are generally known as chemical admixtures. So they added with the concrete ingredients and at the time of mixing itself, so throughout the concrete structure it will get mixed so that it may modify the setting properties of the concrete mix. So as I said earlier, whether you want to make the concrete set very early means that is there is a chemical, whether you want to make the concrete to set little later and again there is a concrete, depends on the climatic condition we are some chemicals adapted. So such chemicals are termed as chemical admixtures. For example, in terms of hot weather concreting, cold weather concreting and all, the admixtures will play a major role in the concrete. Admixtures are added to concrete to give it certain desirable properties in either the fresh or the hardened state. So normally in case of fresh concrete or even in the hardened state, so these admixtures will play a major role. So again, at the time of improve the durability of the concrete in the fresh concrete as well as in the hardened state means to increase the strength by using less water cement ratio so that we can add some admixture. For example, if you are taking M60 grade concrete, if you are using a water cement ratio normally 0.4 example, so that is not far enough for that particular mix, so we will add some admixture so that it may improve the durability of the concrete so that the concrete will have good workability in the site at the time of fresh concrete as well as when it attains the hardened state also the strength will also get reached at its maximum level. Most admixtures result in modifying more than one intended property. So normally admixtures are used for workability as well as strength factors etc. So all the admixtures will play a major role in increasing the property of the concrete. Some chemicals are applied on the surfaces of molds use it to form concrete to affect easy mold releasing operation. So normally before concreting, depends on the climatic conditions or depend on the structural elements or depends on the type of concrete. So those chemicals were applied on the surfaces of the molds to form concrete to affect easy mold releasing operation. Normally in olden days, you may seen in any videos in YouTube or you may heard from your parents. At the time of concreting, normally they used to apply some oils or they used to kept some leaves, okay, and I will try to show some photographs in the last slides. So that tundra they normally used to kept in the earlier stages, the earlier time periods, so that to make the surface very smooth as well as to form the good contact with the formwork. So that instead of that, nowadays we are having some chemicals also, and some chemicals are applied to bond or repair broken or chipped concrete. So if in case of repairs, spalling of concrete may occur in the structure, so that time, so some chemicals are also applied for the bonding agents as well as repair the area which has been failure. And next is a type of admixture is number one, accelerators. So the aim of accelerator, it reduces the setting time, generally produce early removal of formworks and early setting of concrete repair and patchwork. So normally it reduces the setting time, where in terms of required in the project is in very time condition to complete it very earlier, as well as early removal of formworks, so that the other works can be start in the area which where the formwork has been laid, as well as mainly in the advantages repairing of concrete structures and the patchwork. So if in existing structure, if you are going to repair some work, means the accelerator can play a major role to set the concrete early, so that the existing structures can be came to use again early in the early time period itself. So that is a major role of the accelerator. So they are mostly helpful in cold weather concreting. So you know that the cold weather concreting climatic conditions, so even though in some cases there may be minus, so if there may be minus means, so it will, the water content, the moisture in the air will be again more and more, so it will not allow the concrete to settle soon. So if you use the accelerator in that particular point, the concrete will get soon by overcoming the climatic condition. The most common accelerator for plain concrete work is calcium chloride. It's, that is a content in the accelerator, the major content in the accelerator will be calcium chloride. Its quantity in the concrete mix is limited to 1/2% by the weight of the cement. So we know that at the time of concreting itself, the weight of the cement. So normally all the accelerator bag, in terms of if it is a powder means in the bag, if it is a liquid means in the can itself, they will mention that for 100 kg of cement, use this much quantity of accelerator, for one bag of cement, use this much accelerator. So that will be normally printed in the container of the container or packet of the accelerator itself, so that it will be very easily to identify by the engineer or the common public to use in the concrete. So normally it will be 1-2% by the weight of cement. The presence of calcium chloride can cause corrosion of embedded sheets. So that is a disadvantage up here. So you know that the if the more chlorine content is contained in water, means that it should not use it for concreting as per IS 456 2000. So the presence of calcium chloride can lead to corrosion of the steel in the early stages. It reduces resistance against sulfate attack and many cause an alkali aggregate reaction. So you know that what is sulfate attack, which you have studied in the first chapter. So and also to the alkali aggregate reaction. So the presence of calcium chloride content will reduces the resistance against this sulfate attack. For pre-stressed and reinforced concrete, calcium chloride cannot be used, since the pre-stressed and concrete, the grade of concrete will be minimum of M40 and above. So as well as the dia of the bar will be very minimum. Say example, we may say that it is a cables, so that the dia of the cables is very minimum. So if this chloride content more means, it may lead to corrosion. So in those concrete, this type of accelerators are not advisable. So what is the reason why calcium chloride cannot be used in pre-stress? That's what I just discussed in the early slide of the last point. Experience shows that corrosion of pre-stressing tendons, reinforcement and embedded metal usually results from combination of factors including excess addition of calcium chloride. It may lead to corrosion in the early stages due to excess addition of the calcium chloride in the concrete. The concrete means in the admixture. And next type of chemical admixture is retarder. The name itself denotes retarder. So what it will do? It increases the setting time of the concrete mix and reduces the water cement ratio. So that is the main need. It will increase the setting time. So it may For example, if it takes 7 hours, for example, it may this if you are using a retarder, so you can easily calculate how much time required for setting time, as well as reduces the water Simon ratio. Usually up to 10% water reduction can be achieved. So like accelerator, retarder also, in terms of powder or in terms of liquid form, they itself mention about how much quantity can be used for this type of this quantity of Simon. So like that we can reduce the water content in the total arrived water content ratio. A wide range of water reducing and set retarding admixture are used in ready mix concrete. So why the retarders mainly adopt in ready mix concrete means, example, the ready mix concrete might be in outer part of the city, and the concreting, if you are going to do the concreting in the heart of the city, that is center place of the city, so it will take nearly 45 minutes of the traveling time to reach there. So in that cases, to maintain the good workability of the concrete and not to set the concrete, so they will add the retarder at the advisable level calculated by the RMC plant or advisable by the retarder unit itself. They will mix with the concrete so that at that particular 45 times the concrete should not start setting. So that is the main aim of the retarder. So in RMC people, they used to work with the retarders in all types of concrete. Usually these chemicals are derived from lignosulfonic acid and their salts, hydroxylated carbolic acid and their salts, and sulfonated melamine or naphthalene formaldehyde. So these are the chemical formulas which you may studied in your chemistry. So naphthalene formaldehyde, CH3, CH2 and Na, like that you have studied. So these chemicals are derived from, so the retarder chemical is derived from these basic salts. Where retarders are used? So again, for cold weather concreting, it is in very minus temperature, as well as in hot weather concreting, it may lead to 50 plus degree centigrade. So what will happen? So water may, what, there will be no moisture in the air content. So the due to high temperature, the water will start to evaporate. So this will lead to develop more number of cracks. In those places, the water content, to maintain the particular water content as well as the setting time to be maintained in the perfect manner. So these conditions like hot weather concreting, the retarders are normally advisable. As well as you have seen this photo in even in our city itself, they used to have, after laying the concrete, they used to cover with a polythene sheet like that to does not allowing the water to evaporate. So that is the main aim, so that if the water start evaporated, means the heat of hydration process will get corrupted, and then the more minor cracks may lead to the major cracks. Normally we studied in the concrete technology that air cracks will be developed in the concrete after the time of concrete, after the concrete completed. So this air cracks may develop to the major cracks when the water has evaporated in the moisture in terms of very hot temperatures. Retarders have a detergent like property. They work on the principle that water reducing agent migrates to surface of water. This increases the surface's activity and hence imparts a soapy property to the mix and delays setting. So normally you know that when detergents mixed with water or any other chemicals, it will start to have a big foam. As well as this retarder is also the same principle working like that. So water reducing agent migrate to the surface of the water. So this increases the surface's activity and imparts a soapy property to the mix. So you know that what is a soapy property? Again, it develops some foam. So what will happen? It will form at the top of the surface layer. Once this has been framed, what will happen? The water will try to evaporate due to the hot conditions. This material, this property, detergent like property or a soapy property, will not allow the water to the moisture content, so that the water will be remain stay in the concrete, so that it will create a soapy nature, and then it will be instead of setting very early without having enough water content and developing cracks. So this will frame the concrete to the particular time and delay setting, but it will maintain the uniformity of the concrete and maintain the durability of the structure also, and the strength will also attain in the perfect manner by using of the retarders in the concrete. So the main aim of the retarder is to delay the setting and not allowing the moisture in the air. So that is the main advantage of this retarder. Next is plasticizer. So again, this will be termed as water reducer. A plasticizer is defined as an admixture added to the wet concrete mix to impart adequate workability properties. So that is the main aim. Whenever we are working with a concrete structure, we are facing problem with the workability at the time of concreting. So this, if we are adapting plasticizer, this will improve the workability of the concreting. So again, where it required, again in terms of high strength concrete and high performance concrete stages only, starting from M40 and above or M60 and above, that those conditions the plasticizers are must. Normally nowadays we are going for M35 itself, because to improve the workability of the concrete in the field and to maintain the water content ratio as well as the to maintain with the moisture always in the concrete, so we are adapting the plasticizers in the concrete. In general, these chemicals set as dispersants for Portland cement particles. By separating and spreading out the cement particles, internal friction is reduced and workability of the concrete is increased. So this will act as a, some like a chemical in the Portland cement, particularly by separating the and spreading out the cement particles. So the cement particles will get spread throughout the concrete structure. So what will happen when the cement has distributed throughout the concrete, means automatically the workability of the concrete is increased. When cement is disposed throughout the concrete, so workability gets increased, automatically the durability of the structure will get increased. So use of plasticizer is the major role in spreading out the cement particles throughout the structure, that means throughout the concrete at the time of laying. They are divided into three types: finely divided minerals, air entraining agents, and synthetic derivatives. Number one, finely divided minerals. They are either cementitious or pozzolanic materials. They are used as workability aids. They help in reducing bleeding by way of adding finer particles to the mix. So finely divided minerals, you know that how much fine it will be, like sieving, you know that whenever we are sieving in retaining after 90 microns and all, you may feel by touching that very finer particles. So this will be like that much finer fine particles. So they are either cementitious or pozzolanic materials, depends on the properties. It may be with respect to the cement or it may be with respect to the pozzolanic material properties. They are used as workability aids. Again, they used to improve the workability of the concrete, that automatically increases the durability of the structure. They help in reducing bleeding by way of adding finer particles to the mix. So increasing finer particles means how the bleeding is reduced, means so the finer particles will try to take the water content more with that particular particle. So that automatically when the water content added to the finer particles and it will get stricken, means so the bleeding of the concrete, that is overflowing maybe at the top or at the bottom when there is some leakages, so that this bleeding and all will control by the final particles at the time of concreting. You may seen like this, okay, at the top of the concreted surfaces at the end of the day, okay, at the you may notify it like this, as well as like this. This is like a dried surface after 4 or 5 days of concreting. So you may see like this is what. So this is termed as the air entraining agent. This helps in protecting concrete subjected to repeated freeze thaw cycles. Concrete with entrained air has higher workability and cohesiveness. So you know that freeze and thaw cycles. So automatically the climatic changes. So day will be sunny and automatically from the evening onwards, it will start to the variation in temperature. So maybe 30 degree 35 degree in the evenings and started to get down for 10 degrees in the night. So you know that the freezing and thawing cycles will be continuous taken place throughout the curing time period. Okay, so this air entraining agent will protect the concrete from this variation of temperature during the curing period. So concrete with entrained air has higher workability and cohesiveness. So when you're having that entrained air agent, so it will improve the higher workability. Segregation and bleeding are reduced by using air entraining agents. So automatically, so all the admixture's role is to control the segregation and bleeding bleeding in the concrete surfaces. These agents are generally used to ensure durability against frost action. You know that word, the meaning of frost. So this particular agent is used to ensure the durability against the frost action. The previous photo itself, we can identify that it has been developed due to frost and freeze and thawing cycles. So during variation temperature, the air bubbles may develop and it may broken. So again, it may develop, it may broken at the time of concreting. So those bubbles can be adapted. Air entraining agents are derived from synthetic detergents, salts of sulfonated lignin and fatty acids, organic salts or sulfonated hydrocarbons. So like we studied in retarders, so these are obtained from those base as salt contents. These agents create millions of tiny air bubbles which relieve the expansion pressure. So in the first photo we have observed that n number of air bubbles has been developed. So these agents will create, this itself automatically create millions of tiny air bubbles which relieves the expansion pressure. So whenever our body itself get more heated, you know that there may be some type of points in our faces. So it may develop, your mother may, or your father or your grandparents may ask that your body is identified as more heat. So like that, developing air bubbles in the concreting which relieves the expansive pressure. So that should be relieved. Otherwise, it may develop some cracks in the concrete. So this expansion pressure has released with the help of the air bubbles through the air entraining agents. They result in 9% increase in volume of water and osmotic pressure develops as water diffuses from gel pores into the capillaries. So the result of this is 9% increase in the volume of water. So whenever we are using less water, particularly to maintain the workability, so that it will automatically reduce the segregation bleeding of the concrete. Some air entraining agents react and produce adverse effect when used along with the accelerating of set retarding admixtures. So it may react and produce adverse effect. So some may leads to failure also, that is not a problem. But using of air entraining agents, what it will do means it will accelerate also. So that is the main aim. So accelerates as well as set retarding the admixtures. So this may lead sometimes depending on the climatic conditions and depending on the cycles of variation in temperature and very variations. Like example, 45 degree in the evening suddenly going to 10 degree in the night. So this may at this time this may happen as well as the more concreted surface. The size ranging from 5 microns to 80 microns distributed evenly in the entire mass of the concrete. So again, from the photo we can identify that the dia of the air entraining agent created bubbles that may be varied from 5 microns to the 80 microns. So it is again by assumption or by some basic studies, it is only not an accurate one. It may vary, plus or minus it may get vary. Synthetic derivatives, next one. They introduce soapy into the mix. These are surface active agents and are primarily added to increase the workability. The best example of synthetic derivatives, benzene sulfonate. Again, these are based as a salt content. That's what it was mentioned with the benzene sulfonate. So the main of this also to increase the workability. Chemically, they comprise the same chemicals as found in retarders, and hence they also generally retard the setting time. So this will act like also as retarder. These derivatives may react differently with different types of cement. So it is normal. Whenever each and every admixture will react with the different conditions. So based on the assumptions and based on the various studies, we can identify that how much quantity can be adapted to that particular concrete surface or particular type of materials adapted. So that the careful study has been taken with the type of cement. Some air entraining agent react and produce adverse effects when used along with the accelerating to set the retarding admixture. As well as in the previous case, here also it may react and produce adverse effects. Next is superplasticizer. So again, the continuation of plasticizer, only the superplasticizer. It produces extreme workability and thus flowing concrete. They achieve reduction in the water content without loss of workability. Again, this also to reduce in the water content, so that if the reduction water content means bleeding will be stopped, and even though there is a question about workability, but this superplasticizer will create a good workability at the time of concreting. Their use generally leads to an overall reduction in the cost. So this may be reduction in the cost means comparing with the normal concrete, adapting superplasticizer will reduce the cost by the project work completion. So example, early removal of formwork, or having a high strength with the low grade concrete itself, like that those conditions has been referred here. Super plasticizers molecules and cement grains are oppositely charged and hence repel each other. You know that again, super plasticizer molecules have been very tiny particles and cement grains are oppositely charged and repel each other. So this increases the mobility and hence makes the concrete flow in as good manner. Super plasticizer enables saving in cement for a given strength and are ideal for pumping concrete, casting heavily reinforced concrete members and the precast elements of the concrete. So normally in terms of the pumping, so this will play a major role so that it can reach the surface with a good pressure, and as well as reaching the top itself, it's not much important. It should be properly mixed. That is the main aim of the concrete with the help of the super plasticizer. Casting heavily reinforced concrete members, in those cases like grading M60 and above, that might be example in bridges, that might be more number of rods in that particular area. So this super plasticizer will play a major role to increase the strength as well as the quality of the workability of the concrete. And hence the precast elements like precast stages also. So this super plasticizer will save the cement content, so that by increasing the strength, by for example M30 grade can be adapted by adding super plasticizer, it may reach the strength of 40 Newton per mm square. So that may leak. So this is the adapting the reducing overall cost as well as the saving in the cement content. It reduces shrinkage, especially if combined with reduced cement content. Water reduction is more than 6% but less than 25%. So the reduction of water content lies between 6% to 25% of the content, cement content. This super plasticizer is also called as high range water reducer, since 1/4 of the water is getting quantity is getting reduced. So this is this is also called as high range water reducers. So whenever the water reducer will happen, so immediately the bleeding can be automatically stopped. Whenever the bleeding gets stopped, so automatically the finer cement particles will get attached with the other aggregates, so that it will leads to increase in the strength. In repairs of certain structures, particularly roadways and bridges, it may be decided that early strength gain should be as early as possible, so that in case of roads and bridges, the repair work should be taken care immediately, and also the road should be get open to the public within a particular time period, so that only that to reduce the traffic occurs at the bridges as well as in the roads. So in those cases, we adapt super plasticizer at that particular points for improve the strength as well as reducing the time for setting the concrete. The engineer may as a first approach consider admixtures, so that ordinary types of OPC, that is OPC cement, can be used. So whenever we are adapting any super plasticizer, in those cases OPC cements are more preferable, so that it can, you know that why OPC, the final setting time of the OPC will get reduced, is less, final setting time of the OPC is less, so that those cases the super plasticizer can added with this. The chief chemical admixture now used for this purpose as a super plasticizer. So the main purpose is to set the hardened concrete as soon as possible with respect to the durability factor. So that is the main point to be considered here. Formerly, high doses of calcium chloride were advocated, but this procedure has been rejected on the basis of corrosion problems associated with calcium chloride use. So in the earlier slides, we seen that using of chloride content will leads to corrosion. So as per IS 456 also. So this has been rejected in those conditions by having more quantity of calcium chloride used. The time of setting of Portland cement concrete and its strength gain may be shortened by the use of calcium aluminate cement. So that is the main point to be noted here, is it may be get shortened by the use of calcium aluminate cement. Because of problems associated with the conversion, Under hot, humid conditions of the calcium aluminate hydrate from one form to another form, and the resultant strength losses, other types of cements have been preferred. So when the conversion may takes place, so the hot climatic conditions, because of the calcium aluminate, it starts to hydrate from one form to another form. So what happened? So it also loses its property, material property. So the strength will get immediately less. So in those conditions, other types of cements has been started to prefer. So depend on the climatic conditions only, the admixtures has to be finalized as well as the cement quantity to be performed. The strength level is adjusted by controlling the amount of calcium fluoroaluminate in the cement. So depends on the strength. If you want more quantity of cement, sorry, more strength, then the adjustment of calcium fluoroaluminate process can be done. So normal means normally it will be available. So depending on the strength level, if you want a higher strength level with the lower grade itself, then the calcium fluoroaluminate will play a major role so that we can add the content more. The time of set is reduced and the compressive strength also gain in early stages itself. So the ultimate aim of the superplasticizer is to reduce the setting time as well as gain the compressive strength as early as possible. The special cements based on chemical reactions, which are completely different from those of normal Portland or similar cements, are now part of the new technology. This includes fast setting magnesium phosphate and aluminum phosphate cements, which when used for concrete patching for pavements and allow the traffic flow after just a 45 minutes time. So again, with comparing to the previous slides, again here is, so the fast setting, we are adopting magnesium phosphate and aluminum phosphate cements, so it can be used for the pavements so that the traffic can be in the roads and bridges can be opened early, and then the strength can be attained in the earlier stages itself.